is courtesy of the Rolling Stone. And I'm wondering if the Rolling Stone is basically trying to occupy complex position of these nonsense listicle type articles that are basically done to kind of, you know, essentially create debate, create outrage, and get people talking. And why do I say this? Because of this recent article courtesy of Rolling Stone that says, that's titled, sorry, the 20 most influential creators right now. From innovative vloggers to controversial streamers to bona fide TikTok stars, here are the people making a splash of the social media, right? Now, it says the 20 most influential. It doesn't say the top 20, but the way that they've done the list, it gives you the feeling that they're kind of rating them from 1 to 20, right? It kind of gives you that kind of feeling, which I know it's not, because I'm sure it's done in kind of alphabetical flipping order and whatnot, right? But it's pretty wild to see this name featured on there, which I just didn't understand, right? And it's this lady here called Amelia Dimoldenberg, who some of you may know from the Chicken Shop channel show thing that she does, and people just refer to her, myself included, as Chicken Shop Girl. Essentially, the premise of the show is pretty self-explanatory. She goes to a chicken shop and sits down with, you know, very well-known UK artists, and for a sit-down interview in the style of Hot Ones, where they share, you know, a meal of each other and get to know each other in a kind of satirical kind of, you know, way, and with some jokes inserted here and there, what not. And usually people do it during their promo run. Now, for me personally, having grown up in, you know, some sketchier parts of London and whatnot, chicken shops are usually a bit of a meeting spot for a lot of people in ends to kind of hang out, chill out, you know, catch some LOLs, maybe run into a couple of lighties here and there, you know, wrangle a deal with a boss man. But in general, you know, you've kind of been to, if you've been to one kind of ends chicken shop, you've probably been to them all. For the most part, from my experience growing up, for the most part, I legitimately have not been to any chicken shop where I've kind of bumped into an Amelia looking girl on a regular. The last time I've been to a chicken shop where I've seen somebody like Amelia in there was a chicken shop maybe in like Hoxton or Shoreditch, back when I used to go around those areas. So for me, I never understood the premise of the show, because it just didn't, it wasn't congruent. If you're going to get her to do a show where she kind of is the awkward, quirky white girl interviewing the guys from ends, why not just have her do it being herself, which is already interesting, that kind of contrast of having this girl from a particular, you know, basically part of the world or particular socioeconomic level interviewing these other people, artist wise who come from completely different worlds. I think that kind of works, and just have them in just different places. It doesn't need to be a chicken shop. I just didn't get the idea of the chicken shop, like trying to sell it as like she enjoys going to chicken shops. It's like, I don't know, it just doesn't make any sense. You probably didn't grow up around them. You probably don't live around them anyway. So why was this attachment to chicken shop? It's just really bizarre. And then on top of that, with it becoming one of the kind of the biggest and maybe the number one platforms to go on, it also kind of left a bit of a bad taste in the mouth to see somebody quite clearly Caucasian essentially dominating and crushing basically the scene in terms of being the number one sort of like media platform to kind of interview these big stars here in the UK and maybe in far-flung places across the world in Europe and whatnot. It just left a bit of a bad taste in my mouth. You think to yourself, would this show have been successful if there was a black boy or girl on the show? Probably not, right? And that's the kind of sad reality of the situation. But what I'm getting at here is that I don't understand why they have her on the list, because I feel like you're doing this girl a disservice. I feel like, as much as I don't enjoy the show and I feel like she's got, you know, the personality of a cardboard box, I still think some of the sticks she gets online is a bit excessive. But I feel like these things don't do her any favors. Like, why should she be on the list of the most influential people when I don't feel like the show is influential? She may be crushing it. Like I said, the show's crushing it. The views are amazing, right? The views are amazing. She's crushing it. People obviously like the show because they watch it. People obviously see the show as useful part of their media promotion because they advise their artists and their whatever people, their clients they represent to go on it. But no one can sit here, even the biggest fans of Chicken Shop, and say that this show is influential. It's not. I don't care what you say. You're lying. It's not influential. It's good, right? She's doing a good job, but influential is crazy to put it there as influential. And I feel like this creates unnecessary debate, and I feel like takes away from all the good work she's doing. People immediately will say, she shouldn't be there anyway, taking over the thing, the white girl thing, the black girl thing. It just turns into this big debate it didn't need to be. It's okay to have a somewhat constructive debate around kind of the show's success, the relevance of it, you know, the platforming of her, whatever it may be. But putting her in these sort of conversations, I feel like just brings about unnecessary stick that she probably doesn't need. And I feel like having her on the list of the 20 most influential creators on social media is legitimately insane. Because for the most part, people are watching the show to hear the artist speak, maybe to hear how awkward the interaction is going to be, but I don't necessarily think she's the biggest pull of the show overall, personally. Maybe I'm mistaken because I'm not really a fan of the show. Who knows? But I think it's a little bit crazy. Anyway, the kind of the quick blurb on it that features her name, it says here, maybe no one has dated as many celebrities as Dimoldenberg. For 9 years, the London-based journalist, 29, God almighty, man, she looks a lot older than 29 or a lot younger. I don't know, but we continue. Has been taking notables on dates, interviews in the city's fried chicken restaurants in which she awkwardly flirts and deploys her signature deadpan wit. Airing them on YouTube channel Chicken Shop Date that started as a bit of a has become a sensation, attracting stars like Ed Sheeran, Daniel Kaluuya, and Shania Twain. Let's just hope that she doesn't get her long anticipated date with Drake because she pledged it will be her last. So whatever. But I don't know. I just think this is crazy. And putting her as the 20 most influential, it doesn't make any sense to me personally. But again, what do I know? Not going to speak on it too much because when I start ranting and raving about the Caucasians, you know, people are not happy. So we're gonna move off of that one and we're gonna roll on and continue, right? We're gonna just roll on and continue.